Alright guys, so I'm Be Beautiful Because You Are, and this is Musician Mel. How's it going? And we are going to make marshmallows today.
It's gonna be awesome.
Yeah, from like something in the nature.
Yes, natural stuff.
All natural. So, this is what it looks like.
This is our plant that we're gonna be using. It is called the common mallow. And it's very green. And you'll notice these little tiny, they look like cheeses actually. And we're gonna be harvesting a whole bunch of these, enough to fill up a whole cup. So that's the deal.
So that's step one. So we're gonna go ahead and pick a cup of these, which will probably take us, typically takes an hour for one person to pick a cup
one
of
cup.
Them.
So we're hoping to go a little faster with more than one person.
Yeah, so let's see. So this is the plant after it's taken out of the ground.
We decided to just rip it up because it would be easier to pick off the little cheeses.
Yeah, sometimes you can use the root too, as well as these cheeses here. Here you can use it, except it's a little bit more medicine, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. It can be used for like coughs and other sort of, Google it or something.
Might as well.
But it actually has medicinal purposes, and this is what they used to use back in the days for when you were had a cough or you were had a cold or something.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
So
we'll see if we get magically well
using
our marshmallows.
Yeah, if you're a Packard fan, you need to do this. I mean, this is
what you can do during the commercials at Packer parties.
Right. Go pick some cheese up. Yeah, during the football game when it's really boring and you know that everything is going to change during the fourth quarter and the guys are still convinced that their team is going to win, this is what you do to entertain yourself.
Okay, so here we have our little cheeses and Brittany is going to add them to our boiling water.
Okay. So, I will splash. We have 2 cups of the cheese heads and then we have the 6 cups of water.
Yeah, that's great. So we're just gonna try to keep it at a rolling boil until it thickens. I'm gonna turn the heat up here and keep it going, and it might take a little while. So we'll keep you posted.
See you in a bit. Okay, so we're kind of at the halfway point now. It's starting to get kind of milky or syrupy. You can tell that it's not just water anymore. Pretty exciting. Looks like seaweed. Channing said it looked like Brussels sprouts. Kind of is right. Some murky stuff.
See that? See how the end made a string? It sort of like hung on. Watch. See that blue? A little too long. And that was water. Water would not drip like this. When you're making jelly, it makes a similar motion. It's called the gelling point.
Okay, so now we're straining
the cheese balls.
Heads.
Cheese head balls out of the liquid. Oh man, is it gonna hold it up here?
Yeah, we need another strainer.
Let's bucket.
You can actually eat these things, so we should just save them and eat them later.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
you can eat them? Yeah, well then.
They supposedly taste like
salad
peas.
Or something.
Yep.
Like
or soup.
Cheese? You said they taste like cheese?
No. They taste like green peas.
Ooh, yum.
We might want to even strain them more than that, possibly.
Yeah, we can always push. Well, didn't
yeah,
she say?
Yeah, you can push down on it a little bit, maybe.
She said not to push
too much, but we already have color in ours.
Yeah, because if you push it, it'll get too much color into it. Yeah. And you'll get green marshmallows.
Yeah. Well, it's going to have something to do with the flavor, too.
Possibly, yeah.
It smells like spinach, actually. So we're gonna cool this off.
Yep, so now we have to cool our gel.
Yep.
And we're gonna whip up our egg whites. We'll show you that.
Yep.
And pretty much
much we're just going to whip our egg whites till almost like
we get beaten.
Yep, a meringue. Yep.
Yeah.
So I'm just greasing pans right now.
You're actually supposed to use wax paper, but we are out of wax paper, so we're going with the old-fashioned method of grease. Hopefully that will cut it.
Okay, now we're adding maple syrup.
There's no real particular amount, just however amount.
We have to add it to our egg whites.
To be like peaks again.
Okay.
Also gonna add a little vanilla.
Okay. Oh. How much is this?
1 teaspoon of vanilla. Of course, if you go over, it's not gonna kill it. It's a little bit too runny. As you can see, it's not really that peaky. We're going to have to pour it in another bowl, and then we're going to add 2 more eggs and make them fluffy, and then add it back to the marshmallow mixture. Then, so we're going to try that and see if that works, and we'll show you exactly if it works or not. So we'll see. This is all an experiment here.
I can tell it's like thick and foamy.
It's thick and foamy.
Looks like
but...
eggnog.
Right. Yes.
And it actually does taste really good. I think we got our little stiff peaks. Oh yeah. So, going to add our liquid back.
It's gonna be curious.
Back in business.
We'll see what happens. We'll just add some at a time. Cause that is pretty thick. So it's just pretty. It needs more thickness. So,
yeah.
A good feeling about it. Alright, here we go. Gradually add it back in.
So we just added the rest of the half, and we're going to mix it and hope that it goes.
We got full load.
My goodness, it looks gorgeous. I feel like we're in like a candy factory.
Amen.
Willy Wonka.
Yes, he would be jealous right now.
Yeah.
It looks like one big marshmallow. I'm not
it
gonna
does.
Lie.
It's amazing.
Whoa.
Yes,
that's what I'm talking
that
about right
is
there.
What we need.
Woo. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Here goes the fun.
Okay. Oh my gosh, I can just eat this.
It looks amazing.
Let's see. Kind of dollop it. This is what it looks like. How we're kind of spacing them apart because I think they will like expand a teeny bit. At least it seems like they did. Here's some of mine up and already. Looking like peeps. Looking pretty good. They're getting some toasty coloring.
Yay!
It's pretty good.
Here we are with the finished product. They're kind of like macaroons, except for more
marshmallow.
Yeah.
Sometimes they can be more meringue-y, just depending on how big they are, and then some of them are more marshmallow.
Mm-hmm.
It really depends. So here's the grand experiment. Yeah. And then you take
ah, they're a little hard to get off because we didn't have our wax paper.
Mm-hmm.
So,
pretty good on that.
Mm-hmm.
So. But to be honest, it tastes like crap.
Not that great. More sugar, definitely, if you make them.
Probably lots of like peppermint extract, lots of vanilla.
Yeah. they taste green.
They taste like seafoam with like asparagus.
Maybe a little algae. Okay, they're not that bad, but.
Like what?
It's great stuff.
Great stuff.
Yeah,
a
lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, they're like kind of addicting to snack on.
The sugar, that's what makes
probably,
it addicting.
Probably.
I tell ya, it reminds me of something in the green stuff.
Definitely the more neutral.
Warning, they might be bad for you.
Good more ways than one. Do not try this at home. Okay. I don't know. Maybe
maybe we're just picky.
Maybe we did it wrong.
Maybe.
I don't know. I mean, technically, these are supposed to be like what they made back in the days, like for when you were sick, and then. Like, I can't imagine they had all that, like, processed sugar or anything, but anyway.
But we're still eating them, so they're not that bad.
Right, but, like, and so, like, if you were a little kid and you were sick, you'd be like, yo, yeah. I want some, like, cough medicine, and then, like,
makes you feel better? I don't think this would make you feel better.
But if you had it, like, if you weren't used to, like, Quick Trip donuts and, like, stuff
real
like
marshmallows
and, like, McDonald's, then maybe this would be, like, a really amazing treat.
Maybe.
Maybe. Like, the sugar. If, like, normally you were used to eating weeds anyways.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe back in the pioneer days and...
That's a very possibility.
Yeah. Like,
crunchy ones are...
Like, I do not like the wiggly ones when you like, they taste, like, not that great. The crunchy ones are actually
ones
not
are,
bad.
They're not too bad.
Yeah.
Marshmallows. They taste...
Really good.
Pork
one. Exactly.
Yes.
Add a little chocolate. Yeah. I could taste that. Mm-hmm.
Then it could be better. I think if you add chocolate to anything, it makes it better.
And that, yes. I totally concur.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty much the sum. And to sum up how to make them, if you want to see how bad they taste. First, we started with like, okay, we did 3 eggs. Technically, it's only 2, mm-hmm. but we did 3 because they were small. Mm-hmm. And then we mixed those together until it peaks, and then
And then we added our stuff all together,
the syrupy stuff, and then the 3/4 cup sugar.
Yep. And then we popped it on our pan. Yeah. Oh, we put the cream of tartar in.
Yeah. 1/4 teaspoon cream of tartar, and then we did vanilla, whichever.
Yeah.
You want.
To taste, we didn't put enough in.
And before we mixed maple syrup just in the snot.
Yes. The craziest part is that look at this. We still have like
half
a pound
the bowl. Not probably more than half.
Yeah.
And we made a double batch. We only made like 2 cups of the cheese heads.
Like the original recipe we saw called for like 1 cup of the like cheese heads and then 3 cups of water, and we did 2 cups of cheese heads and 6 cups of water. So that's where the problem started.
Yes.
But yeah.
So
curious experiments.
Good luck.
Be brave.
Yes. Yep. So.
One more.
Yeah.
One more for the road.
Bon appetit.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I knew they'd be nasty.
Have you ever chaining? Can I test one for us?
Not good.
I'm smiling.
Kind of reminds me of I don't even know.
Come on.
Definitely would not want one of these at the snowboard.
You want a little snack pack? Take some of those with on the trip.
It reminds me of something, but I don't know what.
Yeah, like a weed. Super green.
It's nasty.
Thanks, Jaden. Thanks.